Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Riverview, where unsurprisingly we are still harvesting and we haven't actually made it to 31 yet. It is however March. Shortly after I finished recording the last episode, it started snowing and the thought of this harvester stops when it's snowing, because you can't harvest in the wet because it reduces yield. Difficult one. Difficult one. Very difficult. But like I say, we do have some things we can be getting on with today. My bales are all fermenting rather nice. Have I just messed something up there? I have. I've spawned a bale. I didn't want to spawn a bale. Put that back in storage. Euro Farmer. He's asking me stuff about the Platinum expansion and the obviously Platinum expansion for Farm Sim, and I don't have it yet. Because, like most people, it releases tomorrow, so I have to wait for Steam. Because I bought the game on Steam with the Season Pass. I have to wait for it to release on Steam before I can install it and start playing it. Although I'm a Giant's partner don't consider me special enough to send me early access, like they have done several other of their friends. So I haven't been able to do any kind of early advanced looks at the Platinum expansion. So I don't really know. I can't answer any questions about it or say anything about it because I don't have any experience with it. And I'm not just going to sit there and make stuff up and pretend I know what I'm talking about like some people do. So I can't help people until I've actually sat down and played with the expansion. I can't really tell you anything about it. I don't know. And I'll find out tomorrow whenever Steam updates the game for me, downloads the DLC. That'll be the earliest time I can have any kind of opinion or input on that DLC. But yes, we have got a field over there to harvest. However, obviously my harvester is tied up doing the contract, so won't be able to do that yet. We do, though, have the option of going and mowing field 18, so I can get my baling done. Now, I can't remember. Which model of them? Vehicle is it? The N175. Which is 201 horsepower. Right. That'll be fine to run the tedder. I was about to grab my little backwing mower and I was like, I don't need that anymore, do I? I've got my big super mower now. Got a big super duper mower. But yeah, we can leave that there. Delores can head back, grab the mower. The new mower. We can do some more mowing. Paying wages very nicely, I have to say. Turn off strong arms, don't need that anymore. I've decided not to bother with the header trailer for this because I can't imagine I'll ever take it from the farm. If I was going to be doing baling contracts, which I probably won't be doing anymore in this series, I may have had to invest in a header trailer to use this, because you can't really get this header across the bridge very easily. This is a problem because I'm swapping. So I'm gonna have to do tedding and then I'm gonna have to windrow again. So right now this is actually kind of pointless. Kind of pointless that I'm windrowing now. Because ultimately, I'm going to have to do it again anyway after I've headed. Unless I do the hay with the square baler, which has got the rakes built in. There is that option, and I'm sorry if I keep yawning, but obviously, same day. Same day recording between this episode and the last. And I'm still very tired following my appointment this morning, bright and early. I've got one next month as well. Got a follow up in a month's time. Again, 9 a.m. in the morning, Loughborough. Bloody trek that that is at that time of day. With the traffic. Well, at least I've got my steam deck, so I can keep myself occupied in the back of the car on the way there and on the way home. That's okay, because we can finish off that other bit when we come back home. A bit overcast. Not the best light to be taking photos, is it? Is it? Yeah, we can leave him. We've got a delivery of oats from field 32. How's the contract doing? 65% transported. Which means this fella is close to getting full again. Doing okay, he's not doing fantastic because he's very slow. It's taking him far too long to do this field. Or whoever that quite miserable looking woman is. Wait for the tractor to come back. At least he's going to be on the correct side, because when the tractor comes back, he's going to come back to that end of the field anyway. So, the tractor's not going to go have to travel so far to unload the harbour. Coming back now, actually. I'm just seeing in the distance over there. He's just on his way now. About to come past the entrance of the field. There we go. come down to the entrance down here. The entrance over there, we'll say. And then he's going to come and hopefully unload the harvester and let us carry on. Let's say these contracts have taken quite a bit longer than I hoped they would. Again, snow has really not helped. The snowfall has not helped. Because it keeps stopping the harvester from actually being able to do any harvesting. Obviously, very bad British winter. Having snow. Might have been an idea to have piped out a little bit earlier there, lady. Or are you going to stop and have a tea break now whilst you're waiting for the tractor to come? That's probably what she's going to do. Sit and have a tea break, isn't she? Oh, it's sweaty. Quite warm today. Despite the fact it's very foggy and horrible outside, it's bloody roasting in this house. Somebody's got the central heating turned up too high. Either that or they've got all the bloody windows closed. Oh, steady on, steady on. He's messed up there. I think it's because the field's on a bit of a slope. It's the tractor's higher than the harvester. Which is not gonna help unloading, because this harvester's already got a bit of a height problem. It's had a bit of a height problem the whole series, as a matter of fact. In that, trying to get trailers under that pipe has been quite the challenge. I was watching Millennial Farmer the other day. One of his recent harvesting videos. And he raised a very good point. Maybe. Possibly. He asked, why is it that nobody's designed and developed yet a combine harvester where the auger is centrally mounted so that it can unload on either side? Why have you not got a centrally mounted thing for unloading? Why has no company designed one and brought out one of those? And I think he challenged John Deere to make one in his video. He says, John Deere, make one. Because obviously he's a John Deere fan, uses a lot of John Deere equipment on his farm. But yeah, I was like, it would be interesting to have a harvester that the pipe is centrally mounted so you can unload on the left or the right. Also, if you had it centrally mounted, it would actually be raised up a little bit. It would be a little bit higher, obviously, and then you'd have a little bit extra clearance for your trailers. Right, I'm in control. I don't want to be in control. Put him back in control. How's my friend doing over here with the graph? Doing well. Yeah, I kind of undo my swaps now by doing the tedding, but what can I do? That mower doesn't have the option to widespread, so can't do widespreading. I think that makes for a better screenshot than the one I took a little while ago, actually. With the mower there in the distance. So I will probably use that one. Rather than just the mower on its own. Plus, it seems to have got a little bit sunnier now. At this late stage of the day. I'm obviously playing with the time quite accelerated at 6 times, so the days go by fairly quickly at this point in time. There's Jack, save scumming again. Hello, Jack. Can't you take a defeat? He will actually, a worker will actually do the head. That's quite impressive. That's quite impressive. But he might get to the end of the field and then go, oh no, no, where to go? And I feel like I'm sitting miles back from the computer today. Because I've got my chair tilted back, so I'm naturally reclining back. And then I feel like I'm miles away from you all. And you can't see me. But if I sit forward in the chair, my back's not supported. So I'm starting to get, I start to get backache then. Could of course do the sensible thing, find the little gizmo, put the chair forward. But then I seem to always feel like I'm sliding off the front of it then. Okay, he's going to do the tedding pretty well. Pretty good. spending a heck of a lot on wages. That's the 7 series. You'll do. How are you? Grab some fuel. Some hay then. Let's produce some hay bales. Wood. Oh, no guesses. No surprise. It's the wanker next door. Looking good. Get out the bloody window by now. Upstairs window on for the lawn. Failing, going well. Mowing going well. There is some rain forecast later today, but shouldn't cause me too much of an issue, hopefully. Just gonna drag them harvesting contracts out though, it really is. I might be very tempted to cancel them out, but make sure come back and do that bit last sort of thing. Also, I still need to mow that bit before I can head it. That'll Right, I will carry on now then, ladies and gents, because I'm obviously going to be fairly busy for the rest of the day doing this and then getting these obviously picked up and transported. Can't believe we still ain't finished them harvest contracts, but what can I do? Unless I get a second harvester. But we will figure things out. I will figure things out. And if I make any grand plans or designs, you'll be the first to know about it. So, ladies and gents, I thank you for watching today's video. Really hope you've enjoyed it. I will see you all in the next one very, very soon. But for now, from me, take care of yourselves, stay safe, and goodbye.